Today we will be deriving the equations of uniformly accelerated motion by E graphical method. Now, whenever we draw a graph in physics, we take one of the two quantities on x axis and the other one on the y axis. However, we have to follow a certain rule, and the rule says that when we take the two quantities, say for example velocity and time, we will have to take the independent quantity only on the x axis. The other quantity goes over to the y axis. Now, if time does not increase, velocity does not have any chance of increasing. And therefore, velocity is dependent on time. But whether velocity increases or decreases or remains constant, the time does not require to change. Or rather, the time continues to change. And therefore, time here becomes the independent quantity. Velocity is dependent on time, and time is not dependent on velocity. And therefore, time being the independent quantity, we will have to take time on the x-axis. So let us plot the graph. We have the y-axis and we have the x-axis. Let me again make it very clear to you that because we are restricting our studies only to linear motion, that is motion in one dimension, velocity and speed would more or less mean the same. At a particular time, say t2, the velocity here will be v. At time 0, the velocity is u. Let us call this as t1. And this entire difference we call as t. As per the graphical method, the area under this line, that is, this entire region, will give us the distance traveled during this period. Now, how do we find the area of this region? The simpler method is that we draw this horizontal line. Now you can see easily that we have, let us name it A, B, C, and D, a rectangle ABCD, and we will have a right angle triangle ABD. It will be easy to find out the area of the rectangle and the right angle triangle, and when we add up the two, we get the required area. So we say area AECD will be equal to area ABCD plus area ABE. Now we all know that the area of the rectangle is length multiplied by breadth. The length will be AD. So we say it is AD multiplied the breadth AD. And and the area of the triangle half base into altitude where your base is AB and the altitude is BE. So we say AB, because it is a rectangle, will be equal to CD. So we can replace this by CD multiply AB. Now what is CD equal to? T2 minus T1, and we call it. Let us keep it as T2 minus T1 into what is AD? It is U. CD again will be 1. Now let us consider this BE. How do we calculate BE? Suppose we have this line where we have a B somewhere here and an E somewhere here, and if we want, let us put this as C. What do we do here? We draw CE and subtract DC from it, we get BE. Therefore, when we have BE, we will say it is CE minus BE. We have taken T2 minus T1 to be T. Now CE is B and CB is U, and therefore we get distance, which is S. We also know that acceleration is V minus U upon V. Take the T on the other side, we get AT equal to V minus U. We substitute this value here and we get opening the final bracket, we get S equal to UT plus 1/2 AT² and this is our equation for the uniformly accelerated motion. As you can see here, the final velocity does not find a place in the equation. So whenever you will be doing your numericals, the first thing that you must do is to list out the quantities which are given to you. Find out what is available. Find out what is missing. If the final velocity v is missing, we use this particular equation. Now let us continue here, and we will get T equal to V minus U upon K. We will be substituting the values of T and T square as V minus U upon K. So we will have S equal to U bracket V minus U upon K plus 1 upon 2 A V minus U upon K the whole square. We have simply replaced the value of T as V minus U upon A. Let us start opening the brackets. UV minus U square upon A plus 1 upon 2 A into V minus U the whole square upon A square. Remember, even this gets square. This A and the square will cancel out. So what do we get? UV minus U square upon A plus V minus U the whole square upon 2A. 2 and what is left here is A. Now this is A minus B the whole square. The identity tells us it is A square minus 2AB plus B square. So let us put it as UB minus U square upon A plus B square minus 2UB plus U square upon 2A. Taking the LCM, we will have to multiply this with 2. So we have 2 bracket UV minus U square plus V square minus 2UV plus U square the whole upon 2A. Now remember, this 2 and these 2 don't get cancelled out because this 2 is not common to everything behind them. So we open the bracket. 2UV minus 2U square plus V square minus 2UV plus U square the whole upon 2A. Plus 2UV and minus 2UV cancel out. The first positive quantity we get here is V square. So we have V square. Minus 2U square plus U square will give us minus U square upon 2A. And what is it equal to? S. Carrying these 2 A here, we get our second equation. 2 AS equals V square minus U square. Now when we look at this equation, we find that time does not find a place in the equation. So So once we have listed the quantities which are already given to us, and if we find that the time is missing, we use this equation. And this is our third equation which we obtain from the definition of acceleration. We will be using these equations during the calculations of our numericals. We will have to find out one out of the five quantities that we have: distance, initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, and time. So these are the five quantities. Any three will be given, and we will have to find either the fourth or the fourth and the fifth. The first thing that you must remember is to list down what is given to you. Once you list it down, you will know which quantity is missing, which quantity is to be found out. Here I would like to give you a few hints. The question would say that a train starts from a station and gains a velocity of, say, v kilometer per hour in t seconds. Now we know that after t seconds, the final velocity is v kilometer per hour, and therefore we know that the final velocity is given. The time t is given. What else is given? Is there anything else given here? Yes, the initial velocity u is also given here. How is it given here? Because it says the train starts from the platform, therefore at time zero the velocity of the train is also zero. So whenever an object starts motion from rest, u is zero, and when a motion comes to a standstill, the final velocity is zero. We continue the question. The train continues at velocity v for a certain time period t1, and on reaching the next station, it takes x time. So at the next station, the train will stop. The final velocity in this case becomes zero, and the velocity v becomes the initial velocity. So don't go by the letters, only go by the wording of the numerical. So it is very important that you read the numerical first fully, right to the last question mark. Read it fully, don't leave it halfway. You have done hundreds of numericals. You have done this particular numerical which is asked in the paper 10 times. You already know the answer before beginning your calculation. But in one case, distance may be asked, and you have always performed this numerical to find the distance. But in the question paper, it is time or maybe final velocity which is asked. So unless you read the entire numerical, you will not know what to answer. And therefore, it is important that once you read the numerical fully, you understand what is the question. am I supposed to calculate for distance or I am supposed to calculate for angular velocity? Once you understand the question, only then start answering it. So please don't infer anything in your mind. Read the question fully, understand the question, and then start performance. During performance, like I have been telling you before, you must convert everything into meter per second when it comes to velocity or speed. Distance must be converted in meter and time must be converted in second. No choice. Acceleration will be meter per second squared. So distance in meter, speed velocity in meter per second, acceleration in meter per second square, and time always in seconds. Convert everything to the SI unit and only then perform the operations. Look at this. V minus U equal to AP. Now this equation does not incorporate distance. So here, when distance is not given, here when time is not given, and here when final velocity is not given. Acceleration and initial velocity are needed in all the three equations, and many a times you will not be given the initial velocity, in which case first use this equation to get your initial velocity and then continue with the question. If acceleration is not given, find the acceleration and then continue with the required question. So two quantities are compulsory while performing the numerical, either acceleration or initial velocity. If one of the two is not given, you will have to find it first and then you can continue with finding whatever is asked of you to find. I think it will be all this time. In the next period, we will be doing a few numericals. However, your homework will be to write this down three times with the graph.